Hi everyone, Heather here. I am here today just to give you a short tutorial on how I'm going to create some rose petal overlays. I'm doing this for a project that I'm working on that hopefully I can share with you soon. So I just wanted to give you guys a tutorial so that you can go out and create your own overlays if you wish to. My little daughter just threw them up in the air and I just tried to capture a few images of them on the backdrop here. I used a gray backdrop because I thought that it'd be easier to select the flowers from. So I'm just going to take my magic wand here and I'm going to click on the gray backdrop. And then you can hit like the shift sign to add the little plus there to get some more. Black in there. And just going to zoom in here for a second because I'm noticing just a small little gray spot here in this flower that I want to get. And that looks good right there. So now I'm just going to hit the select and mask up at the top. And I actually just brought the shift edge all the way to the end because I didn't want to risk having any gray in there. I might bring it down just a little bit, maybe at like 48%, just so I don't have that like a gray along the edge of the petals. I want to avoid that, so I'll hit okay there. Now I'm just going to invert this. I'm going to go select, invert, so that just the petals are being shown here. And I'm going to go Control J to put them on their own layer. So now that they're on their own layer, I'm going to actually delete the backdrop here. And then I'm going to go File and Save. Let's just try to save it as a TIFF this way. We'll say yes. Okay, so I want to bring this up here. The TIFF options, because I want to keep the transparency of the background. So all I did to get this up was I went File, and then I went Save as a TIFF. And then I'm just going to click the Save Transparency, and then I'll hit OK. And so that will mean that when I open this file up again in Photoshop, the transparent background will still be applied. Let me just open an image here. Okay, so I just decided to bring up a photo in Photoshop so I can test out the layer and the TIFF on that file. So I'll go back to my rose petals and I'll just go layer and duplicate layer on that photo I opened. And there it is. We want to turn it into a smart object. Just go Control T and just kind of play around with this here. See what it will look like. You can also play with the, you know, you could go up to filter and blur the layer if you want to. Something like that to make it look like it's closer to the camera. I hope this was a helpful tutorial and that you can make your own overlays. If you're interested in purchasing these rose petal overlays, they will be in my shop. You can just follow the link to my shop at the top of my page. Please like this if you found this tutorial informational, and if you want to get more tips and more tutorials like this, please hit that subscribe button and the bell so that you don't miss out on any of my new videos that I post on Fridays. Thanks again, and we'll see you in the next one.